Asha, did you do the medicine? Who have not read the syllabus yet? Everyone read the syllabus? And okay, before the class time, I would like to commercialize something. I have class 4000 all new. Think about taking it with me. Anyone need to take 4000 in evidence study? Something? Just all new, right? Where's all new? Okay, alright. Independent study 4,000. If you don't have enough credit to graduate, you may need to take something. Okay, if you want to add that as soon as you can, okay? We wait for 10 more seconds and we will start, right? Okay, you should be ready by now. Sentimoment, did you watch the video? Who, O'Neill, did you watch the video? No? In the homework, you are asked to watch the video and do the summary of it, about 200 words. Do you know that there's a homework?
Yes.
On the blackboard?
Yes.
Who cannot download it? It's take not long, a little bit time to do it. 1 hour, 2 hours, and you should be done. That's average student, of course. If you're below average, you will take longer. Last time, we talked about gas contract. And in the homework, you are asked to summarize what are the topics in the gas contract. So you just say, okay, the gas contract that we learn in class is just one part of the actual gas contract. The one that we learn in class has ownership, allocation of the product, gas specification, metering, standard of the meter, and who pay for the operation. Okay, not many words, okay? That's to summarize, but I want you to know that this is just the part that we need from the gas contract. Gas contract is longer than this. Okay, and we talk about revenue calculation. Hydrate a little bit. So in the exam, of course, you will ask to define what is hydrate. That is very likely, okay? May not be, but very likely. And how does it look like? It looks like ice, but it has methane inside. So we talk about this, and a little bit on this part. Okay, jetty cooling. Okay, this is where we left. Okay, we have flow through a choke and temperature drop. To look at the chart to find out how much temperature will drop when we have pressure drop. The chart look like this. Very quick. And then, two. Okay, Papa. All right. So this is pressure enthalpy diagram. It look crowded, okay? But you will use it. I upload a clean version for you to see it and probably give you during the exam. So this is a clean version for methane, okay? Hope you can see it. It's a methane. Pressure enthalpy diagram, okay? What we need to know is flow to a chalk is a constant enthalpy process. Capital H stay the same, okay? Enthalpy stay the same. Enthalpy, it's over here, that's enthalpy. It should stay the same. So on the left hand side is pressure. No problem with this, right? Easy. The temperature line, there are many lines, okay, and it's quite crowded. So temperature line, when you see this line, that's for temperature. Okay, temperature look like S curve. So it look like this, something like that. So in the actual chart, on this side, it is minus. This is plus, okay? So if we have the temperature of 160 Fahrenheit, so the unit is T is in Fahrenheit, okay? This graph. So if we have 160 Fahrenheit, first step is to find that line, okay? Where's 160? Of course, you cannot do zoom in something like this. But okay, this is 0, 20, 40, 80. I get my 160. See 160? So 160 look like this. Okay, that is 160. Good? Everyone see the 160 line?
Yeah.
All right, next step is, okay, let's say, to do the temperature drop calculation, we need to know the pressure drop. So let's assume that we drop from 4,000 to 1,000. That is a pressure drop. 4,000 psi. So over here we have 4,000 psi line and 1,000 psi line. Easy, right? And that is the line for 160. Okay. At 4,000 psi, it cross with 160 somewhere. That is the point where it cross. Good? So it dropped from 4,000 to 1,000. That is 1,000 psi line. Okay? The drop is constant enthalpy process. So when we say constant means doesn't go up, doesn't go down. So we just draw a straight line going down like that. Easy enough? Next step is to find out what is the temperature at that point, the cross point. Okay? To find that, I need to know other temperature line. So you see this line? That is only how much for that line? Can you see it?
80.
80. Right? That is 80. And this one is 100. Good? So that point should be somewhere between 80 and 100. If it is at the middle, could be 90. So if it is a little bit to the 80 degree, it may be 85, 86, 87. I cannot tell. Okay, so how do I have something that better? How do I do it better than guessing? Victor. That's Victor. Hi, Victor. How do I do it better? Do you have any suggestion? Okay, I don't know the equation. Let's say you go to work and you just have this chart, my PDF, and you want, they want to know, okay, is it more than 90 or less than 90? Can we tell?
Less than
90. So, what you can do is print screen and use paint and count the number of pixels and then use calculator. Okay? Seriously, that's how you do with the resource that you have. So click print screen and draw a line and find out how many pixels. Do you know how to do that, Victor? About 90. So everyone know how to use this chart, pressure enthalpy diagram. Okay, there are other charts to use. So this one is for methane. I gave you another one for ethane. Okay. X-axis, okay, let's take a look. Enthalpy, or this edge. That is the x-axis. Flow through a choke, enthalpy stay the same. Okay, it doesn't move, it's just this, okay. There are several other things in this chart. Like, you see this line that make us confused? That is S, entropy. Okay, the line that look like this, that is entropy. Don't use it. It's not the right line to use. The line that look like this, that is specific volume. Okay, V, that's specific volume. Specific volume, you see. Cubic foot per power. Don't use that. It can tell you the density too, right? Okay, so let's go to the next chart. Is it okay if this is in the exam? Yes, you should be able to do this, right?
Oh, yeah.
So in this one, I show you with the graph that we have, where I draw a line, a red one, pink one, to show you that the curve, like S-shape, that is the constant temperature line. When we find the point, we drop directly because the flow through a choke is a constant enthalpy. Good? Okay, let's do something else. How about this one? We talk a little bit and it's time's up. Okay, let's go through it more. This one is also in the homework, okay? This one is in the homework. So previous graph is when we know that it is a pure component, right? If it is just methane, we use that graph and it's correct 100%. For this case, if it is natural gas and we have no other information, we don't know the average molecular weight, we don't know that, we don't know anything else. We just know it is natural gas. And okay, we may know over here say BBL per million standard cubic foot. Okay. We may know that at the stock tank, we have 20 barrel per million standard cubic foot. We just know that. We use this graph for a quick estimation of the temperature drop when we have pressure drop. Okay, for flow through a shock. This give you a quick estimation. Okay, look at this one. Vertical axis is temperature drop in degree F. Horizontal is initial pressure or pressure before the choke. This line is delta P. Okay, delta P is P initial minus P final. Alright? So if I have temperature start at 120 Fahrenheit before the choke, and upstream of the choke, the pressure is 4000 psig. Or if it is PSIA, it's just quite the same, right? You just add 14.7, so 4,000 and 4,000 with another 14.7, it is somewhere over there, doesn't change much, okay? So after the choke, we know that the pressure become 1,000 PSIG. Okay. So delta P is 4,000 minus 1,000, right, Victor? Good? Okay. So delta P is 3,000. Delta P of 3,000 is this line. See that line? So I start from 4,000, go up until I reach that line, and move to the left. The temperature drop said 80. Okay, the temperature drop said 80. So 80, one thing that I want you to know that, okay, you see small handwriting over there. So this chart made based on gas stream with 20 barrel per million standard cubic foot. So this means if I produce condensate or oil 20 barrel per million standard cubic foot, I don't have to do any adjustment. Okay? So without any adjustment, after the choke, okay, let's find somebody else. Vivian Nenkep, N-E-N-K-E-P. That's last name. First name V-I-V-I-A-N-E. Drop, okay. Ernest Munoz. No, not here either. Trey Mondin.
Ready.
Hi Trey.
Hi.
Oh, you again, okay. So what do you think? If we have temperature drop of 80 and we start at 120, what should be the temperature after the short tray?
You said it dropped 80?
Yes.
From 120?
Yes.
40,
right?
Yeah.
Okay, correct. Very easy, right? So that is for the case where we produce 20 barrel per million cubic foot. This chart say that if we produce nothing, okay, let's say we produce nothing, we produce no oil. If no oil produced, we have to use this one and use minus 10. And take a look at how do I use minus 10. Okay, so when I use minus 10, instead of 40, I use 40 minus 10, become 30. Done. So if I produce no oil, 0 barrel per million cubic foot, I get 40 and I minus another 10, it's become 30. So that is the temperature after the choke. Okay. If I produce 40, okay, 40 barrel, so the temperature will be what, Trey? If I produce 40 barrel per million cubic foot, what is the temperature after the choke?
It'd be 10 more, so
50.
Right?
Correct. Yes. Yes, sir. That is correct. Easy. Very easy. You guys look so serious. It's just that easy, okay? It's just that easy. But you need to know how to do it because this is in the homework and it should be in the exam, right? Because you can do it. And you see, I have intention to pass you all. Every one of you. Okay, now look at another one. This one is entropy diagram. They call Moller diagram, M-O-L-L-I-E-R. Moller diagram is the diagram between enthalpy and entropy. I just told you that, oh yes sir.
On the previous chart, to go back to the correction, why does the temperature like go up, like the correction factor?
In the, which book? Gas Association book, they said, the chart was made based on 20. Okay, if we produce less liquid part, okay, temperature drop more. If we produce more liquid part, temperature drop less. So if we produce 40 barrel, okay, so instead of go all the way to 40, which is the final temperature, 120 minus 80 is 40, right? So instead of 40, temperature should drop less when we produce more liquid. So instead of go to 40, it's go to 50. The reason that the temperature drop less when we produce more liquid is that liquid has the heat capacity a lot more than gas, right? So heat capacity of oil is about 2000. Heat capacity of air, 2000, that is in unit of joule per kilogram per Kelvin. Heat capacity of air on natural gas is dependent on pressure and density, but it's a lot less. So if we have the same amount of temperature drop in gas phase, liquid absorbs some of heat and releases it. So when we produce more liquid, the temperature drop less. Does it make sense to you?
Yes.
Kind of, okay, based on heat capacity. Moiler diagram. We use the same trick for Moiler diagram. Pressure, when pressure drop, and we how do you turn off this? Yeah, never mind. Let's continue, but please help me. So for pressure drop through a choke, okay. Light off. Okay, light off. I feel better. Thank you. E-R-I, last name Ames Kua. Eri, what is the parameter that stay constant when we have JT cooling? This one or that one? Enthalpy or entropy? H, right? Correct. So these things stay constant. Okay. The way to read this chart is somewhat different. See this, that number, 14.7. 14.7 is that line. That is the pressure at 14.7. That is pressure. So this line is the pressure at 10,000. What about temperature? Temperature in degree Fahrenheit. You see that 32? That is constant temperature line. So like this line is 500. Okay, 500 Fahrenheit. That is constant temperature line. So the only question is, if you have pressure drop, what is the final temperature? We do the same thing. Okay. So this one, I try to have pressure drop from 4,000 to 1,000. Okay, from 4,000 psi. So 4,000 psi is that line. That line, right? 1,000 psi is that line. Good? And then I start at 120 Fahrenheit. 120, so that is 100, and I know there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 scale, right? So 120 has to be one more step up. So that line is 120. Okay, so 120 cross with 4,000 psi. That point is our initial condition before the shock, correct? So after the shock, we know the final pressure, but we don't know the final temperature, correct? We don't know the final temperature. So what I do is I draw a constant enthalpy line. So just move to the right hand side like that. Draw a constant enthalpy line until it meets with the pressure line of 1000. And I start to read the temperature at that point. Over there. Very difficult to read, okay? But it is somewhere between 32 and 40. This graph tells me that. Okay. One thing to mention is this graph is for 0.6 gravity of natural gas with the critical pressure of 672 and critical temperature of 360 Rankine. Okay. The previous one, we don't have any information about specific gamma, the gravity. We don't have any information about specific gravity, right? When we have more information, we should be able to do it better. There are several of this graph. This one is for 0.6. In the textbook, there are for 0.7, 0.8, 0.9 or something. Okay. There are many graphs like this. Your task is select the right one. Just that, okay? If it is 0.6, select 0.6. Okay. So now, let's do something with a little bit more calculation. Okay, show calculation with hydrate curve. Everyone sign the sign-up sheet? Who haven't signed it yet? Oh, could you please give it to him? Okay, so show calculation. In the textbook, Silver Ink textbook, okay, we have line heater. Inlet pressure is 2000 PSI. And we choke it, and pressure after the choke is 750. Specific gravity is 0.7. Gas flow rate is 3 million standard cubic foot per day. Okay. Inlet temperature is assumed to be at the hydrate temperature, 71. That is our assumption. So basically we know pressure and temperature at inlet. Anyone else haven't signed it yet? How many of you drop? Or Ernest drop, okay. Malik, Ahmed. No one has to sign underneath it? So this is the most updated list, right? Everyone's name is in here, correct? Good. Oh, we have some drop. So we want to know what should be the outlet temperature. The first step is to know outlet temperature, okay? The textbook gives us a chart that looks like that. Chart looks like that, you see? Now let's get to know it more. Look at this axis, okay? Horizontal axis is pressure in PSI. A. Vertical axis is relative enthalpy in BTU per bar mole. Okay. Bar mole, how much is bar mole? Victor, do you know how much is bar mole? So if I have 1 bar mole of carbon, how many bar is that? Pardon me? One. Melissa, how many? If I have 1 pow mole of carbon, so how many pow is that? One. Next to Melissa, what's your name?
Kelly, how many pow is that? You don't know. Okay, what's your name?
Chris.
Chris? If I have 1 pound mole of carbon, carbon molecular weight is 12. Okay, if I have 1 pound mole of carbon, how many pounds is that?
12 pounds. Correct.
So what a pie. It's very easy. Too easy, right, Chris?
Yeah.
Too bad. Okay, too easy. But maybe I have bad English accent or something, maybe that's caused some confusion. So everyone know it now, right? 1 pound mole of carbon is 12 pound.
So Chris, if I have 1 kilogram more, or let's do medicine, okay, give you a second chance. If I have 12 kilogram more, or if, no, 1 kilogram more of C12, that equal to how many kilogram? 1 kg more of carbon, which is C12, right? 12 is the molecular weight. 12 is the molecular weight. So how many kilogram? 12 kilogram. Okay, correct. So if it is methane, one mole, when we say mole, there are several kind of mole. Sometimes it's pound mole, some people say pound mole, some people say kilogram mole. In chemistry, they use gram mole. So it is one mole, but that one mole is not the same mass. We need to know what is that. Is that gram mole, kilogram mole, or something? Okay. So in this text, they use pound mole. Okay, they use pound mole. Lb dash mole is one thing. It's not pound multiplied by mole. No, it's pound mole together, one thing. Okay. So this time we have several graphs. Okay, we have specific gravity of 0.6, specific gravity of 0.7, and it happened that the gas that we try to choke it has a specific gravity of 0.7. Okay. We know the inlet pressure, which is, okay, let's go back, 2000. And after the shock is 750. So I look at 2009, that is 2000. So that is 2000. Good, that's pressure at 2000. And then I look at 750, that is 750. Okay. And at the shock, oh, there are more lines to look at in this textbook chart. Look at the dashed line. You see that dashed line? That dashed line is hydrate temperature line, hydrate formation curve. They write it very small, but that is very important, okay? That is very important. That is hydrate formation curve. So we assume that inlet temperature is 71 at the hydrate formation curve. So basically, is it over there? Okay, that is 71 and pressure of 2000. And we use line heater. Okay, the actual question is, what is the heat duty in BTU per hour that we need? How much heat that we have to put in? We have to answer a question before that. We cannot just jump into that answer. First step is, I have gas, I need to know, I will heat it, yes, I will heat it to what temperature? So we need to know, we heat it, but it will end at what temperature? So we will heat it. For this example, we heat it just enough that it will not form hydrate. Okay. So one type of line heater for this line heater is a single pass. We heat it first and choke later. Okay. Heat first, choke later. This appeared in 2015 and 16 exam. So for the single pass line heater, do we choke first or do we heat first? Your answer is heat first, okay? You need to know that we heat it first. We will heat it such that when the gas goes through the choke, it has temperature drop. Once it has the temperature drop, it should stay outside the hydrate curve. So we heat it hot enough. Let's say hydrate will form at 40 Fahrenheit. If we don't heat it, it will drop below 40, so that's not good. So maybe we heat it very hot, and when it goes through the shock, the temperature drop, but it's still higher than hydrate formation temperature, so it doesn't form hydrate. So that's good, right? That's the strategy for this one. And I need to know I will stop at what point? Should I hit? If I hit it, okay, very hard. 160, okay, let's say I hit it to 160. Hitting too hard in the line hitter, wasting money, okay? Hitting is money. You have to put energy into it to hit it, right? We don't want to hit it too much. Plus, if you have some liquid, that's liquid vaporized, or it's also natural too, you don't want to hit it too much. So if we hit it, temperature, you see this is a temperature, right? That temperature, 20, 40, 60. So when we hit it, enthalpy go up, right? Enthalpy go up. So the strategy is, when we hit it, enthalpy go up, and when we flow through a choke, temperature will drop. It will drop at a constant enthalpy, right? So when we hit it, it go up, and we choke it, the pipe move to the left. So when it go up and move to the left, it should not, it should end at 750 line. You agree? Because we try to choke it to 750 PSIA. Okay, we try to choke it to 750. So, and we don't want hydrate. The trick is, we look at 750 and find out. At 750, what is the hydrate temperature? Can anyone tell me? Matt? Matthew R. Santa Cruz? Hi Matt, can you tell me at 750, what is the temperature that hydrate start to form? What do you think? I know that you sit so far and you cannot really read it, but I saw that. 61 degree, yes. So basically, we draw this line. When it touch with another dashed line, which is this one, right? And then we try to read, what is that temperature? So that is, this is 60, and it's so close, so Silva say, okay, it's 61. Good? So we know that after the choke, the temperature, the minimum temperature should be 61. If it's below 61, it's bad. If it's above, it's fine. Oh, but it just come. What happened? Can you sign your name and say that, what time is this? Miss the class, okay.
Do you have
university skills? Could be. He looks sick, but still want to come and learn. Okay, very good. Oh yes, question.
So on the heart rate formation curve, the dash line, why does it go up above 80 degrees right there today?
Where does it go up above 80 degrees in here? I don't know, that's the way it is, that's what they say. Okay. I don't know either, I will have to find out and tell you why should that be. You may expect that at a higher pressure, the hydrate formation temperature should be at higher value, right? So like 4,000, it should form hydrate easier than 1,000, right? You agree? So at 4,000, we may be able to form hydrate at higher temperature because we have higher pressure. So when I look at this graph, if I have higher pressure, so I can form hydrate at a high temperature. If I have low pressure, I have to cool it down more to form hydrate, correct? So I have to cool it down more to form hydrate. But if I pressurize it a lot, I don't need to cool down much, okay? But that graph suggests something else. Right. The one from the Silva's textbook say Okay, if I have a 4,000, I need close to 80 to form change a little bit. It's maybe change from 75 to 61 or something. I still don't know. I don't know if this is correct, but we use it and it look correct. It change a little bit. Okay. When we move this way, it is a constant temperature line, you see. So to answer your question properly, I don't know. Okay. Silvers say like this. The thermodynamic packet show you actually this kind of curve, the full one, and it tell, okay, when you have temperature drop, where's the location in the hydrate curve? Good? Oh, Ernest, you missed, you not just missed. You know, after 30 minutes, it's missing the class. Good? You may have university excuse, let's talk to you later. Okay, look at this one. The strategy is to heat such that final temperature is 61. Okay, so if it is 61, it doesn't form hydrate. So this means we heat it just enough. And when we go through the choke, pressure drop, so the temperature, but enthalpy stay the same, and it stop at hydrate line. Got it? Very good. So if I, let's say I use this chart, I start at 3000, okay? And I choke, and I do at N at 1000. So maybe I start at that point. How much do I heat? So I heat it just enough. So I try to find out the cross point, right? So that is my target. If I can heat it, heat go up, right? And when I choke, pressure drop, enthalpy stay the same, and I stop at that point, then I about to form hydrate, but not form hydrate. So this will tell us the minimum amount of heat. Okay, minimum amount of heat for hydrate formation, below which we form hydrate. What you read from the chart is not just the temperature, not just the final temperature. We have to use this value, relative enthalpy. Okay, so we know that we heat from the enthalpy of 2300 and M at 3200. The enthalpy difference is how much? 900. Okay, good. The enthalpy difference is 900. And we produce 3 million standard cubic feet per day. 3 million standard cubic feet per day. Okay. So the question is, how much heat in BTU per hour? How do I do that? I want BTU per hour. I don't want BTU per pound mole. Okay. The answer is, Chris, you still with me?
Yeah.
Oh, just look at the screen. Okay, okay, I understand. So, use another chart. That's the answer. Easiest answer is use another chart. Use this one. See what's figure two. Okay. So this figure, we have total heat required in BTU per hour on one axis. On the horizontal one, we have enthalpy difference. Okay, enthalpy difference. So what we do is, we go from enthalpy difference. Enthalpy difference is 900, right? So we start at 900. And then we know that MMCFD, the flow rate is 3 million. So that's number 3, right? 3 million. So that is the line of 3 million. So I go from the enthalpy difference of 900 up until I reach that point. And then I read the value of total heat required in BTU per hour. Done. Use another chart and I know BTU per hour. Clay Cunningham, where are you? Do you understand this?
Yes, sir.
If we don't use the chart, is there a way to calculate it? Yes, of course. Yes, of course. Who made the chart? The chart just pop up out of nowhere? No, right? Probably you will be the one who made the chart, not just use the chart. How do we make the chart for someone else to use? There has to be the way to create it. You agree? Do you want to know just how to use the chart, or do you want to know how to make the chart? Make the chart would be better. Give you the job, okay? So we try to do the conversion from BTU per hour into, not BTU per hour. We try to convert from BTU per pound mole into BTU per hour, okay? So this is just heating the gas that is in the line. So when the gas comes, if gas come more, we have to heat more, right? If gas come very fast, we have to heat even more. If gas comes slowly, we heat a little bit, then it reach the final temperature. So look at this. If you have this 0.3 mmCF per day, so you heat just that. That is 30,000, not 300,000. Okay. So we heat a lot less. And if we, so how do we make the chart? So we go back to gas law. Capital R, gas constant, is 10.73159 cubic foot PSI A divided by degree Rankin multiplied by power mole. That power mole is one thing, okay? There are several R number of R constant in the Wikipedia. You have to select the right one. It may come instead of PSI, sometimes it's ATM. Instead of degree R, sometimes it's Kelvin. So we have to have the unit consistent. Good? So we go back and we say, okay, let's say the standard pressure is 14.7 PSI A. Standard temperature is 60 Fahrenheit. So 60 Fahrenheit at 459.67, that is a conversion to Rankin, right? Correct? Good. So now let's do, how much is the volume of 1 pound mole? You know how to do that? Ashley Kerr? Do you know how to do that? Yeah, is this the equation that I show? That one. We have PV equal to NRT, right? At the standard condition, Z or compressibility factor is 1, correct? So I want to know the volume, I just put P to the denominator. So it's NRT over P. So it's NRT over P. Just that. N is 1. R is 10.73159. T is 519.67. And pressure is 14.7. I put all that into the calculator, I get 379.38 cubic foot. So this means 1 pound mole is 300 and something cubic foot at a standard condition. Everyone is with me? Good? So gas flow rate that we have is a lot. It's 3 million, right? So it's 3E6. That is total gas flow rate. So that is 3 million cubic foot come for 1 hour. Okay, so I try to change cubic foot to pound mole. 3 million cubic foot equal to how many pound mole? I know that 1 pound mole is 379. So 3 million equal to 3 million divided by 379 equal to 7,107 pound mole. So we have 3 million per day. In the unit of pound mole, we have 7,907 pound mole per day. Can I change from pound mole per day to per hour? So if one day I get that much, if I take sample just 1 hour, I should get that much divided by 24, right? Correct? This is what? You agree? Okay. Divided by 24, then we have 329 pound mole per hour. Okay, that is what we have. We know from the chart that the heat required is 900 BTU per pound mole. So that is the heat required. And we multiply BTU per pound mole with this should be this, okay? Do the correction in your slide. So BTU per pound mole multiplied by pound mole per hour, we get BTU per hour. Good? So I get something close to 300,000 that we got earlier. Done. So we don't need to use the chart. Without the chart, we can do something like this. So we know the heat requirement, BTU per pound mole, we know how many pound mole we have, how many pound mole per hour we have, multiply them together, then we know BTU per hour. BTU per hour, that is the power in the fuel unit. Eric Faulkner, what is that power in SI unit?
Which power, the BTU per hour?
BTU per hour is the unit of power in the fuel unit. What is that in SI? Skip to the one sit next to you. What's your name, sir? Oh, you want to go that side, lady first? Okay. What's your name, man?
I don't know either.
What's your name?
I don't know what it is in that side.
Okay. Who do you want me to call next?
Who do I want?
Next to you. So what's your name? Next to Ashley, what's your name?
Haley.
Haley? What is BTU per hour in SI? What did Google tell you?
No.
What? What? It has to be in what? W-A-T-T, what? So BTU is the unit of energy. Energy per time is power, okay? Equivalent to BTU in SI is Henry? Joule, right? Joule is the unit of energy that is equivalent to BTU. BTU is what? British thermal unit, amount of energy to raise water of 1 unit, 1 pound, 1 pound of water with 1 Fahrenheit up. That sounds reasonable for you, but you never learn anything like this. Just me. So please know SI unit. I think I should ask. If you don't know, I should ask so that you know. Let's ask that in the exam. How about that? And who make it wrong get -1 or something. Okay, now let's move to light heater. So you know how to use chart and do the calculation by yourself, right? The only thing that we cannot do is this one, BTU per pound mole. How do I make the chart? How do I make this chart? How do I make this chart for natural gas? That has to come from thermodynamic calculation, thermodynamic package, because we don't have this one is for pure component. Natural gas is a mixture of methane, ethane, propane, butane. So it's not a pure component, right? It has several things together. And then we cannot directly use this. Okay. So you can do this. Line heater. So heat the gas so that when it has pressure drop across the choke, the gas is still above hydrate point, hydrate temperature. Okay. We heat it first. When it goes through the choke, the temperature can still be higher. There are several types of, I think there are two types of line heater. Sometimes we heat it first, we choke, and we heat it again. Okay? Or we just one pass or split, not split, we will talk about that. So line heater are more common and less expensive than LTX and easy to operate. So the question that you should expect is, generally LTX is more expensive than line heater, true or false? Haley?
True.
True, okay, good. Line heater look like this. You have seen it, right? Have you? Yes, yes, say yes. Yes, you have seen it. Several people have seen line heater. Did you, Chris, did you see this line heater before? No, okay, now you have seen it. It looks like this. Okay, line heater is just a coil. It's a coil for gas to flow inside.